Hello everyone and welcome to Usitility. Today we are going to see how to play Epic 7 on PC using the brand new BlueStacks 5, that is designed for blazing fast speed and high octane action. We will be able to easily download and install Epic 7 and enjoy the game on our Windows PC with keyboard, mouse and big screen thanks to BlueStacks 5, which is the Android emulator that we recommend to play Epic 7. So without further ado, let's get to it. First of all mates, the first thing to do is to open our favorite browser. We open the one we prefer. Let's go to this URL that I have highlighted in green. There you are seeing it on the PC screen. You don't need to type it, simply because there's a clickable link in the description of this video and the first pinned comment. We landed right here on our internet site of Usitility, exactly where we include a detailed demonstration on how to download Epic 7 on personal computer. We scroll down a bit and just click on the Download Game on PC button. After clicking on the link, we land here on the site of BlueStacks, which the Android emulator that we will run to enjoy the game Epic 7 on the PC. As you can see here, we get a great deal of advantages of preferring using this emulator. Now we will proceed to download the Epic 7 by simply clicking on the button Play on BlueStacks that you can see here in green. Next step is clicking on it, and the download starts and ends immediately. Voila, this is the download. It is an executable file. What we are going to do is to launch the executable file, so we have to click on the file. If we are on Windows 10, it will have asked us for permission to make changes to the system. We said yes. I minimize the browser to view the installation software better. The installer is straightforward. It includes two possibilities, install and setup path. I am going to show you what setup path does. We simply click on it, and we observe that we get here the path where in fact the emulator can be set up. If we plan to change this directory, we must click on this Browse option, and we opt for another folder and set up the emulator specifically where we want. I prefer to leave it where it is. Then, I click on Back, and I simply click on Install. Now, there it is. The installation starts and it's going to progress together with the download of those megabytes that happens to be displayed on the computer screen. At the time you download it, it may be slightly more or less MB. The download speed can be faster or slower, determined by your web access and according to the velocity of the emulator web servers. Today they're going incredibly fast. The download is finished, and now it proceeds with the installation phase. With BlueStacks 5, you can even reduce RAM usage with a single click. Especially useful if you ever face performance-related problems. In addition, you can activate Eco Mode to enjoy 87% reduced CPU usage, 97% reduced GPU usage and easier multitasking. As you can see, BlueStacks 5 is built to provide stability and performance during long gaming sessions. The installation has already finished for me. Now, the emulator has been launched immediately. As you can see, down here, there is a progress bar which will advance to the right, then when it reaches the ending, the emulator will be launched for the very first time. In reality, the emulator was already launched, here for the very first time. Before we continue, as you can see now, it made two app icons here on the computer desktop. The BlueStacks and BlueStacks multi-instance. Note that the BlueStacks icon is the one we're concerned about. Anytime we would like to run Epic 7 on the desktop or laptop, we double mouse click on this particular app icon and run the emulator. The BlueStacks multi-instance icon allows you to launch multiple emulator instances. And with BlueStacks 5's new improved multi-instance manager in Eco Mode, players can run more game instances faster and with less lag. Let's perform the next step, which is actually a must-have, and that's to log on to the Google Play Store. And we will simply click on Play Store. As you can discover, the Google Play is launched. There we must sign in. At this moment, as soon as we are right here, we are required to perform the next phase, which is mandatory. So that we just click on Sign In. Now it says, Checking Info. It may in some cases get stopped at Checking Info, and this fails to move forward. If so, you could try to connect to your account after a number of hours and it'll usually be fixed. Now we will type in our email and password. The email must be a Gmail email and its corresponding password. For instance, you make use of the very same email you're using currently in your own YouTube account. Then I am going to type in my information and I will go back when I have completed it. That's it, details inserted. And here is Google welcoming us and providing us their terms of service. We must accept them by simply pressing, I agree. Next, it offers us to backup to the Google Cloud. You might keep it checked and this will create a backup of the data on that device to Google Drive. I am not going to check it, you do what you want. We click on Accept. Google Play is launched by default and immediately. To set up the app game, we have got to go to the emulator desktop for Android by clicking on this app icon indicated green colored. Now that we are watching the desktop of the Android emulator, we observe that we have now here the install game button. We mouse click on this button. Here we get the video game. Let's quickly mouse click there on the install choice that I'm highlighting now in green. And it will begin the setup. At this time it should install the game. It might take a little while or perhaps it may be almost immediate. It again all is determined on our own internet connection. This has actually ended installing. Now, let's go to the emulator desktop by hitting that option I'm presenting in green, that allows you to launch Epic 7 for the very first time. We are by now on the emulator desktop, and then we're about to mouse click on this fresh Epic 7 icon that has been generated. The video game is launched for the first time. Currently there we get it. I can mouse click anywhere on the screen and also make use of the keyboard. I will comment on the volume of this emulator. This is here, we have got the icon of higher volume and the icon of lower volume. This way we will not count on the Microsoft Windows volume to increase or decrease the audio of your emulator. And to enjoy the experience to the max, we should activate the big screen, for which we have two options. This is the first one, we mouse click on that icon which I am actually pointing out in green. And the screen is maximized, getting one border at the top, one at the right and one at the bottom. In case we wish to appreciate the app in full screen, we press on this icon. And we might by now be experiencing the video game in 100% screen mode. To stop the full screen mode, click the F11 key. And consequently we would likely by now end up being in standard computer screen setting. Now I am starting to reveal you the keys mapping and that is actually rather interesting. This way we may be in a position to use the game application a lot more easily. The first thing is to click on this application icon. And there you will be able to make the appropriate adjustments. I'll go ahead and leave the normal configuration, but if you choose to adjust it, you may very well do so with no problem. Perhaps you have realized, the emulator is totally in our language. In some cases it happens that your emulator is launched in the wrong language, for example, in Japanese. And consequently to set it in the correct language we click here to the cogwheel. And here within various other configurations, we mouse click on the language drop down. We can choose the language we want, Italian, Mandarin, and so on. Once the language is determined, we could save, the emulator would restart, and the Android game, the next time we start it, would as well be in the selected language. At this moment, there's another aspect that we need to take into account, and it's that we will receive a message from Google saying that a new equipment has been associated with our Google account. It definitely will check with us if we're the people who have connected that device. That's right, we should not get worried, considering the fact that emulator is simulating in Google Android electronic device. And to discover which electronic device is currently being emulated, we visit here, to the cogwheel and we then click on it. And we go here to the model option. And there we realize that the emulator is acting as a Samsung mobile. And so we're going to receive an email saying that a new Samsung device has been connected to our Google account. That's all folks, so much for this video tutorial. I believe you enjoyed it, especially that you found it handy. If that's so, allow it a good thumb up, subscribe, and I will be happy to answer your feedback, concerns or suggestions, let them in the comment area below. You could possibly also leave a remark on my Twitch channel, I perform live streams on occasion, you have it down below in the video description and in the first pinned comment. Click on any of the videos which are usually showing up on the screen and see you in the future videos. Bye.